Good afternoon, everybody. The time is 1:15 p.m. Pacific Standard Date, 7/29 of 2019. Beyond Meat, the one that has turned out to be up 800% before it fell down from that 240 mark. We have an after-hours low print on the earnings there that was down at 211 right here. We shot up initially right here around that 234 and some change. Right now, the bid and the ask is right here. It's 1227 by 1228. They missed by 16 cents on revs. And now they're trying to say what that missed there. What a gimmick this is. Fiscal 19 revs above consensus. So basically, it's 16 cents worse. They were supposed to be losing 8 cents a share. Revenues rose 286.8% year over year to $67.3 million versus the $52.71 million. Now, just by looking at the report, primary due to an increase in sales volumes of products and our fresh platform across both our retail and restaurant and food service channels, driven by expansion in the number of retail and food services. So basically they crossed a profit of $227 million or 33.8% as an average percentage of net revenue. By looking at the report, whatever that this stock could have done at 800% gain since the IPO, which was only a few months ago, this stock is priced to perfection. And even with those numbers there, by missing by 16 and then coming back in and using that little accounting gimmick and try to put revs above their 52 million and whatnot, it wouldn't have mattered if they would have beat and how big it would have upgraded. It wouldn't matter. And we're currently at 224. Once again, sell the news. Stock has gone up to 800%. They just released their quarterly report. They did miss by 16 cents. They're trying to take the sales revenue up by about 8 million. And that's all that we're getting it. And we're going to have a conference call. We can see here that we just had a little spike right there to 232. And that low right here, just to give you an idea, the low of this wick right here is 222. They spiked it right back up, and we're starting to come right back in here now by 226, by 226, and some change. This is the level two in the after-hours price print. So the conference call will be underway, and we'll find out what they have to say, and then we're going to figure out why they are giving a higher number based on their projected sales, which is only a projection, and that's all it is. And so that's based on the new order activity that the company is seeing. We'll be back in a minute. Now, I've got a 220. They beat. We're not happy with that number. The stock is up 800%. This thing is going down. And I wouldn't be a bit surprised on those numbers if we don't drop below 200. The time is 1:32 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. The date is 7/29/2019. And you're here live with the free option traders. When I said they pumped this stock, and this stock is going to go down on that earnings release, as you can see it here at 214, and you can see the spike right up here at 234, and then they came back up right around 232 almost, and we're printing right here at $211, and this stock is going down, and we're going to come back to it. But you need to read it and you need to weep it, because that's what they said. Oh, We beat on revs. Oh, we're going to raise guidance. Look at it now. This is live. It's 203. It's 202. I said it was going below 200. I said that over here. That's live. We're going down below 200, and I wouldn't be a bit surprised if it doesn't get more right down there around the 175 area, whether that's this afternoon or tomorrow. I just know one thing. When these kinds of stocks and this kind of volatility, with that percent gain going into an earnings report, it was doomed to do what? Get trashed. And here it is right now. This is what happens to people when they get into these IPOs, that volatility. So we hit 197, and we're right back here at 202. And it's going to be up. It's going to be down, just like you see it now. And you know what we call it? Sell the news. Sell the news. The volatility of both directions will continue to go. Once again, 702-685-0772.